Start. Yes. Mr. Vice Chairman, sir, I join my colleague in thanking the President for his address. At the very outset, I would like to point out that the problems of the state government of Tamil Nadu have not been mentioned in the address, especially the burning problems in Tamil Nadu and the needs of the state of Tamil Nadu. Though the government of Tamil Nadu brought these problems to the notice of the government of India a number of times, the government of India has not taken note of them. For example, the Kaveri River water dispute has been pending for a long time, in spite of the tribunal's interim award, which has not been implemented. The Sethu Samaram project, which has been pending from the British days, has not been attended to. It was started by the Congress government and four committees have been constituted. All the committees have recommended it to the government of India to implement this project. But the same Congress government has not taken any action in this regard. About the southern gas grid, all the southern chief ministers, including the Congress chief ministers, joined together and passed a resolution. They are prepared to contribute funds to the government of India for this purpose. But in spite of that, the government of India has not taken any decision. Take for instance the railways. There is no project in Tamil Nadu. The existing capacity is being taken away. The Congress party also say like this, along with the Congress members from Tamil Nadu, but nothing has been done by the government of India. The Congress members must go and press this demand outside in their party fora. So the feeling is that Tamil Nadu is being neglected. This is the feeling which the government of India must take note of. The government of India is emphasizing that the ongoing liberalized economic policy, globalizing the Indian economy through reforms, is irreversible and continuous, and the same thing is being repeated. At the same time, the government of India wants to convince the people that the direct foreign investment is more in the core sectors, in the infrastructure sectors, and not in the consumer goods sector. Our Honorable Prime Minister, in his address at Davos, has emphasized that foreign investment is preferred only in the infrastructural sector. For example, power. I was happy to read that speech, but what really happens? More foreign funds are flowing into the speculative stock market. The share prices increase steeply. The foreigners are cornering the shares of the Indian industrialists.